Hello friends, good morning, good afternoon. As you are aware that we are discussing centroid of composite figures, and I hope you are also doing exercise at home, solving some numerical problems from standard books or the problems from assignments which are uploaded on the website. So today I will take the problems which are little bit complex in nature. Okay, let us take this is a problem. Locate the centroid of the plane area as shown in figure. What we have done, this is a rectangle you will find, and this part is removed. This part, that is a semicircle, half circle, is deducted. And for rest of the figure, this rest of the area, we want to calculate the centroid. Coordinate system is given, and if not given, you assume as per your convenience. This is x coordinate and this is a y coordinate. So how you will break this? First, what we'll do, we will take the total area rectangle, and then we can take this area as a minus. Okay, so I will call this is a 1 and this is part 2. Okay, radius of the circle is given 60, and center, coordinates of the center, y coordinate is given. You see, y coordinate of center is 120 and x coordinate is also 120. See, this is also 120. The center, coordinates of center is given in the problem. So first let us take a rectangle. For rectangle, I think you don't have any problem. Rectangle, you can write down area 120 by 200. So 24,000 is the area, and x coordinate will be 120 by 2, that is 60. Y coordinate will be 200 by 2, that is 100. You can write down A1, X1 here, and then A1, Y1 here. Now for rest, you see, this I have shown a rectangle by dotted line, and the circle will have to deduct. So area of the circle will be minus, since we are deducting, that area is removed, minus pi r square by 2. This is area, and this is a minus, that you should not forget. Now this is the center of this is center, and this is the centroid of the semicircle. Okay, so you know from the base, the centroid of the circle lies at a distance of 4r by 3 pi up to this. This distance is 4r by 3 pi, and total is how much? Total is 120. This total distance is 120. So 120 from this up to base is 120 minus this 4r by 3 pi. So we got it 25.46. Is it okay? Then y coordinate of the, you see, it lies on the axis of symmetry which passes through the center, and coordinate of center is 120, and that's why y coordinate is 120. It is a 120. So we got area of this semicircle which we want to deduct, and that's why it is negative. So A2 X2 you write here, then A2 Y2 you write here, and then take summation of area, summation of AX and summation of AY, and now you substitute in the same equation. We got total summation of AX is 12.97 × 10⁵, and total area is 18345.14, and hence we got X coordinate is 70.69 mm. Similarly, Y coordinate, we got total summation of AY 17.215 × 10⁵. Area, this and this is same, and if you calculate this, you will get y coordinate of centroid is 93.84 mm. So I hope it's clear. You try to solve. If any difficulty, you can ask me in Google class. Okay, this is one more problem. which is same, that this is the semicircular semicircle and this circle is removed. This is removed. So I will divide this, first I will take this entire semicircle like this, this complete, okay, and then this part will have to deduct, this part will have to deduct. So I will call this as a 1 and this as a 2, okay. So let us take first part, upper circle, 150. So what is the area? Pi r square by 2. Now this is the, you see, coordinate system is passing through centroid and it is symmetrical about y-axis, and that's why when figure is symmetrical about y-axis, x coordinate is 0. And y coordinate is, you know, 4r by 3 pi, that you can calculate. You take a1 x1, this will 0, then a1 y1 will be this much. And then this area only will have to deduct for second circle having radius 100. So minus pi r square by 2 minus x coordinate is 0, y coordinate is 4r. R is 100 here. Here r is 150, here is 100. 4r by 3 pi, you got this value. So a1 x1 again 0. a2 x2 is 0 and a2 y2 will be this value. So total summation of area you take, summation of x will be 0 because both values are 0, and summation of ay will be this much. Why we got ax is 0? Because figure is symmetrical about y axis, x coordinate will be 0, and that's why it is 0. So that there is no need actually to calculate this. Just if you observe the figure carefully, it is symmetrical about y axis, there is no need to calculate x coordinate, it is 0. Because centroid lies on the y-axis, centroid for both figures, it lies on the y-axis. So x-coordinate is 0 and y-coordinate, if you take a1, y1 plus a2, y2, we have calculated in the previous slide, that is 15.84 into 10 raised to 5, total area is 19635 equals, so 80.67. So centroid lies on y-axis from origin at a distance of 85.67. So in this way, to practice some more examples, I think we have solved sufficient number of examples on the composite plane figures. So with this, I conclude today the composite plane figures, and in the next class I will discuss the centroid of one-dimensional element, that is wires, cables. That way, that we'll discuss in the next class. Thank you.